We spend a lot of time on this channel talking about knives that I love, the best knives for Alaska, and many different of my favorite knives for different applications. And while that is certainly a lot of fun to talk about, today I thought I would talk about the opposite end of the spectrum and talk about four knives that are probably at the bottom of my barrel. Now, this is not necessarily a list of knives that I hate or dislike, but this is my least favorite knives in the collection, the ones that I'm least likely to grab. Now, these knives aren't necessarily bad. It doesn't necessarily mean that they're weak or that they are fragile or that they're just poor performers. Well, sometimes, but these are just knives that don't really fit me or my tasks very well. Still have them in the collection to have them and to roll them into videos, obviously to make points and such, but these are probably my least favorite knives. So without any further ado, please don't forget to comment, like, share, subscribe, and check out that Patreon. It really does help out the channel a lot. So let's jump into these four blades. So this is number one, the Glock FM81, I think it is, they call this. And the first thing I dislike about it is its sheath. It is really an awkward sheath to try to withdraw the knife, especially one-handed. But this is the little knife itself. Now, this is almost more of a bayonet, but it is marketed as a knife, so we're talking about it as a knife. And this little guy right here is an amazingly resilient knife. You can beat the heck out of it. And I did a video not so long ago, well, actually a while ago, but it recently went up, talking about this knife, and you know, like I did a proper review on it. And once again, it's not the worst knife, but for me, it doesn't perform very well without some serious modifications. And as a whole, the upper and lower guard kind of make it hard to use for my applications. The root saw is not the greatest either for my applications of batoning. It definitely chews batons up. And overall, it's just not a very comfortable knife for me. And like I said, it's hard for me to use it in the ways that I want to use a knife. So for me, it's just one of my least favorites in those regards. Probably not a bad combat knife, but just not a good knife or good fit for me. Once again, the sheath is really weird and very hard to open or get the knife out one-handed. I think you might be able to do this little like number here or maybe like that. That's really about the only way I can get it open. So that is the FM81 by Glock. Once again, just not one of my favorites. Okay, the next one and the next up on the list for price is the SRK-C or the SRK Compact. Now, this is probably actually one of my favorite knives on this least favorites, but admittedly, this is just not one of my favorite knives because it has big shoes to fill. This, of course, is the smaller version of the very well-known, very well-loved SRK. And the primary reason why it's just not my favorite is because the SRK exists and I would rather use the SRK over the SRK-C. And there are a few reasons to that. One, this is a smaller knife than the SRK, and that is, of course, the whole reason why it is a C or compact or why it was made. But I really think that the SRK is, for what its intended use as a survival knife, is in a good size, weight, thickness category. The other thing that you'll notice when you hold an SRK-C is the weighting just feels weird on them. They feel very blade heavy as opposed to the SRK, the standard or the original, that feels very evenly balanced between the handle and the blade. This one feels very blade heavy, and the handle overall in thickness is much thinner than on the normal SRK. So when you're holding it, it is not as filling in the hand. And you'll notice another knife on this list also has that same complaint. But once again, the SRK as a knife just performs better than its little brother, the SRK-C. And so while it's not a bad knife, especially it's an okay budget bushcrafter or budget survival blade, I would still recommend the SRK though, unfortunately, because the SRK is so similarly priced. So if you are going to go for one, unless you specifically need the shorter blade length for whatever reason, I really think that the SRK is just the better way to go. So the SRK-C has to be on the list. Like I said, I just don't really think, given its own kind of competition within the family of the SRKs, this one stacks up quite as well. So that is the SRK-C. And like I said, it's just really a weird weight and not my favorite size. Okay, next one on the list is one that we love to hate around this channel, and that is the Gerber Strong Arm. Now, similar to the SRK, this Gerber Strong Arm, for whatever reason, the ergonomics is just very weird, and actually the SRK-C is better at filling up the hand than this one, but for me, the ergonomics have never really quite filled my hand just right or quite well. So for me, this is a mildly to partially fatiguing handle to hold on to and use the knife for any long period of time. Mix that with the fact that it does have the upper and lower guard, so it's hard to put your thumb up on the top of the tang. It just really lends this knife to not being very usable for my specific wants or uses. And in addition to that, I think it's also a very overpriced knife for what it is. Now, it is true, it is made in the US and it is a full tang blade, so it's pretty robust, but it is only 420HC and the edge retention just really is lacking. I mean, all the other knives on this list have better steel than the 420HC here, yet this knife is the third most expensive. So yeah, this one really just, it does not check any boxes, and I find it overall to be just a little bit too small to be a right and proper survival knife, and a little bit too weird to be a good bushcrafting or camp knife. So the SRK-C definitely has to join this list for those reasons. Okay, last but not least is actually the SC4. Now, some people may not like the fact that the SC4 is on this list, but truly speaking, and having a lot of SCs, everything from the Azula 2 up to the Hunglis 2, this knife really, out of all of those, is my least favorite to carry, or the one that I gravitate towards the least. Now, I will say, especially with this handle, it does look really cool, but I think that the thickness of this blade is just a little bit much, and I find myself, for the overall size and shape of the knife, I find myself gravitating towards the SC3 far more often than the SC4. And it's primarily due to the fact that the SC3 is just a little bit smaller and quite a bit thinner. So when I want to use a full flat grind for doing slicing tasks, processing game animals, processing natural resources, the SC3, for me, makes a lot more sense than the SC4. So that's the primary reason why I kind of throw the SC4 on the back burner. It is not a bad knife by any stretch of the imagination, but similar to the SRK, you know, when you have other family members in the kind of tree of knives, you end up finding that, you know, maybe some of those other knives in the family are actually superior for your uses. Now, I do think that the SC4 would probably make a pretty good knife overall, but being that I have a kind of use for a smaller, you know, sub 10 inch, sub 9 inch knife in a kind of camp roll, the SC4 just kind of falls short on that one. So that is the SC4 and why it's on this list. So overall, those are my top four least favorite knives in my collection. Once again, a lot of them are not my least favorite because they're weak knives or because I don't like where they're manufactured. A lot of them are really solid. You could beat the heck out of any of these knives and they're not going to break. So that is definitely a plus. And they are still quite high quality, except for maybe the Glock and the Gerber. But overall, these knives just don't check boxes for what I intend to use them for or what I like to use knives in their particular size range for. So hopefully that kind of helps you guys clear up some of the lack of desire to carry these knives. And if you don't see them prevalently on the channel, just know that that's why. Okay, guys, as always, God bless, and I'm out.